You guys are first? How exciting. Hi, everybody. My name's Dave Kelly. If you can hear my voice, I'm going to be the MC here today. I'm also going to be the one reading your kids' names out, your students' names out. And I couldn't say how excited and proud we are. Just for technical reasons, we just need to test something. Could you all just honk your horns? Can we hear your horns? Very good. Can we just get, are there any, if you have a grandparent in your car, could you please honk your horn? Very good. Grandparents, just so you know, in about an hour is when you get to pee. So we're going to try to make this go as quickly as we can for all of you. This is how the day is going to work. First of all, this is the most exciting graduation ceremony in the history of graduation ceremonies, and we're very proud. If you have people at home that are watching this, we were having technical trouble with the Facebook Live site, but if you go to Drive-Thru Grad 2020, Drive-Thru is spelled T-H-R-U, drivethroughgrad2020.com, it's streamed there. So if you have folks at home, text them. The announcement's up on Facebook anyway, but just in case, let them know that if they go to Drive-Thru Grad 2020, they can watch this entire thing, and it's going to sound and look beautiful. The way this works, all of the grads are lined up in these cars. I'm going to announce their name. When we announce their name, we honk and yell and we make it fun and exciting for them. And then when we get through everybody, they're all going to be lined up in the first few rows. And then what we're going to do is we're going to have some, we're going to have a little bit of a formal ceremony. Very simple, and it makes a lot of sense. Even if it's not your son, daughter, niece, nephew, or grandchild who's graduating, when I announce their name, please feel free to yell and clap and scream, honk your horns, slam your doors. Just avoid doing burnouts in the parking lot. That doesn't work. But anything else, go crazy. Are we all ready for this? One more test. Can I hear everyone's horns? Are we ready? Yes, this is exciting. Look at this gown. We're going to get started in just a sec. Thanks, everybody. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome with me today our first graduate, Alexandria Talbot. How are you? And our next graduate, would you please welcome Brandon Corno. Zoe, you're down with Will. Zoe Nicole Brown. Awesome. Are you guys ready? And now, ladies and gentlemen, go ahead up, Zoe. Our next graduate, would you please congratulate with me, Zoe Nicole Brown. Ladies and gentlemen, our next graduate, congratulate with me, Paige Kellis. Who's the rock star? That's impressive. This is Sage the photographer. All right. Okay, you go up to the X and pose for your mom. Our next very proud graduate, please congratulate Tate Henderson. You did it, Tate! going to wear the same dress. I'm so glad you
It's my mom's wedding dress.
Is it?
It is.
Oh, what's your first name?
Philadelphia.
Oh, I love that name, and I saw you here. Polly?
Are we ready? Oh, my gosh. And ladies and gentlemen, our next grad, please congratulate with me, Philadelphia, Polly. And I know you're all wondering, is that her mom's wedding dress? Yes, it is. Congratulations.
Come on over here. Come to me. This way. Yeah. Mom's good. First name?
Emery.
Hi. Within, come closer. None. E? Emery or A?
E-M-E-R-I.
There you are. Ready?
Yes.
We do it? And now, congratulate to our next grad with me, Emery Kulkulin. What's your name?
I'm AJ Garcia. AJ Garcia.
Awesome. You're going to be up high. There you are. You ready?
Yeah.
You walk to the X, smile for the camera, and head back down. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Head on up. And now, would you congratulate with me, AJ Garcia? Good work, AJ. What is going on? Will, how you doing? You ready for this? Here, give him an elbow. High five. You're going to go to the X, stand there and be beautiful, and then come back. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the man, the legend, please congratulate Will Davies. What's your first name?
Kendall. Kendall Smith.
Kendall with a K?
Yep.
H-I-J-J-K. Where you see it? Where are you?
Right there.
Oh, there you are. Good. Yep. All right. You're going to walk the X and smile.
Okay.
It's very cool.
Okay.
You ready?
So hard. Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. Kendall's been practicing this for 12 years. Would you please congratulate Kendall Smith? Cole, my name's Dave.
Thank
it's
you.
Amazing. Cole Peterson?
Yeah.
Awesome. So you're going to walk to the red X when I see your name.
All right.
We're just going to wait for the photographer, that is your car, to get organized. You walk there, you smile big, and then you go. This is awesome.
Yeah.
Cole Peterson. All right. Head on up. Our next graduate for the class of 2020, Mr. Cole Peterson.
Appreciate it.
What's the first name?
Dorian.
Dorian Ferris Brown.
And I guess I'm going to tell you that I'm the picture.
Oh, awesome.
And look at the car.
Oh, that's so great. So, you'll be on your cell phone.
Okay.
Turn off, you don't use Bluetooth, and just talk on your thing. Be
sounds
easy.
Good.
It's awesome.
Cool.
Okay, head on up, Dorian. Thanks so much.
Thanks, appreciate it.
And now, our next grad, please honk with me for Dorian Ferris Brown. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Okay, first name?
Jenna.
E-F-G-D, there you are, Jenna
yeah.
Hassan.
Yeah.
Saying it right?
Yeah.
So, pretty easy when I say your That was close.
You don't want to get that wrong.
When did I walk off?
When they'll wave at you. You'll know. Good question, though. Okay, head on up. Oh, wait, wait. Actually, yeah. Take your time. Stop. Stop at the top so that we let that car. I'll wait till you're out there. You guys go ahead. And now, are you ready, Jenna? Let's hear it for Jenna Hassan. I'm awesome. I'm Dave. What's your name?
Josh Halcrow.
Josh, there. Halcrow,
yeah.
Saying it right? And now, your next class of 2020 grad, Josh Halcrow. So awesome, eh? Hey, you wore purple. What's your first name?
Aiden.
Aiden. I like that. Aiden Smith? Look at you, even got your name on the window. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for our next grad, Aiden Smith. Ladies and gentlemen, part of our next class of 2020, Shay Jackson. Take it away. The next grad in the class of 2020, Haley Carlson. How's it going?
Good, man.
What's your name?
Hunter McChesney.
I love it.
Hunter, once your car's there and ready to take pictures, yeah. I'll send you up. It's easy. You just hit the red X. Look out there for your adoring.
God, thank God.
That would have been funny.
That would have been awesome. And now, your next very proud graduate, Hunter McChesney. Are you guys ready? Are you ready for the picture? Yeah? Okay, head them on up. Your next grad. Please congratulate with me, Mr. Brock Saunders. Name? With an A?
Yeah.
There you go. Will come Linton?
Linton.
Your next graduate is Azura Welcome Linton. Our next graduate, walking the stage for the first time in his high school career, Jacob Bowd. Let's hear it for Jacob. First name?
Amy.
Congratulations, Amy.
Thank you.
Amy Nielsen, saying it right? Okay. Yeah. Once your folks' car is set up and they get a nice picture, I'll send you up. You just walk up to the red X, look this way. Your fans will go crazy. You know, it's standard. You can even climb up to the top of the stairs if you want to get that out of the way.
Yeah.
You ready? Here we go. It's going to happen, Amy, the moment you've been waiting for. Let's hear it for Amy Nielsen.
First name?
Damien, D-A-M-I-A-N, last name Michaud.
There you are right there, Damien.
Damien's folks, you ready? I want to make sure you're ready. Good for you. Okay, Damien, it's all yours. The photographers are ready. The hat's looking good. Let's hear it for Damien Michaud. Trinity, congratulations. This is a big deal. You did great. Trinity Bergman?
Bergman. Yeah.
Got it. Okay.
And now with the shortest car in the grad.
And you're going to walk to the X and look out.
Would you please congratulate Trinity Bergman?
Come with me. She's got pictures to take. Who's going first?
I'll go first.
Okay, name?
Julie Elliott.
Julie. There you are. And your name, just so I'm ready?
Rebecca Elliott.
All right. Rebecca. So you'll walk up to the X, look this way. Julie first, right?
Yep.
Take it away, Julie. Head on up. And now, your next grad, Julie Elliott! And wait a minute, we've got more. It's Rebecca Elliott.
How are you? I'm Dave. What's your first name?
Molly.
Molly Gillespie.
Yes.
Saying it right?
Yep.
Good for you, Molly. When your family's ready to take the picture, that's your, which car is that you?
Yeah, no. This
that
is
one.
My car.
So when that car's over, I'll send you up.
Okay.
Stand on the X. And
that's
a lot
good.
Of people do backflip, round off
right,
splits.
I'm
whatever.
Ready.
How exciting is all of this? Your next graduate is Molly Gillespie.
How are you?
How are you?
What's your first name?
Skylar Farney. There's me right there.
No, I like Farney. Say it right.
Farney. Yep.
When I say it, we're going to wait for your family to get their car in the right place.
Okay.
You're going to walk to the X. Look this way.
Our next graduate, put your horns together for Skylar Farney.
Lexi Wilson.
Alexi or Lexi?
Lexi Wilson.
Jay, there you are. Good job, Lexi. So once your car is over, that's your car here. So once they're in position, I'll send you up. You stand on the X, you look out, your fans scream, they throw money, you know, the standard thing you're used to. Just look at your dad here right now. Look over here. There you are. Okay, head on up. Just wait one sec, Lexi. We'll let him move up. Okay, take it away. And now, please congratulate with me, Lexi Wilson. That is some seriously good honking we have going on. If I go da 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 da, nice work.
What's your name? Isla SW. You can just say SW. This one right here.
Isla? Oh, why not? Schmidt.
Schmidt Wasalinja.
Why not? It's okay. Your full name.
All right, go for
that's
it.
You here? White car? Let's wait till they're set up. Good. Okay. Yeah? Head on up. And now, with one of the longer names we have to pronounce, but the best one, Isla Schmidt Wasalenchuk. Congratulations, Isla.
Hi,
Taylor Pearson. I probably will remember, but I just want to look at it to be sure.
Okay.
So, once your car is set up, all right, Taylor, this is your chance. Taylor was telling me she's a little nervous, and I'm saying you should be. This is a big deal. Please congratulate Taylor Pearson! Come on over, it's you. I'm Dave, congratulations.
Thank
What's
you.
Your first name? Right? We want to get it right. Are you ready?
Yeah.
You're
going
to walk up to that red X and look out there, and their fans will scream for you. All right. Our next contestant on The Price is Right. No, wait a minute. On Grad 2020, Izzy Stevenson. Dave, what's your first name?
Leslie.
I gotcha. C-H-I-K. Leslie.
Marzan.
There you go.
Yeah.
You're ready. So, we'll wait till your car is ready.
Okay.
And then you're going to walk up to that red X, look out. Your fans will go crazy and scream for you, and you wave, and then you're done.
Okay. Can I do a dance?
You do whatever you want,
yeah?
Yes.
Okay. I'm doing a little dance.
You do?
Yes.
All right. I don't want to get anybody too pumped about our next person, our next graduate. But Leslie told me if there's enough honking, she will dance. Would you please welcome to the stage, Leslie Marzan!
It's Nyla.
There you are.
Yep.
How do I say your last
Nyla
name?
Nyla Cathal.
Is she the last one? Okay, I want to get this. I lost you again. L-M. Nyla Cap. This is your final graduate of this group. So would you please make it count for Nyla Cathal? Are there any parents or grandparents who didn't graduate that would like to get it done now? We just have a couple of, I'm just kidding. I wish we could. How exciting. So let me explain a bit about what's going to happen now. While Nyla and her family find their place to their seat, I think we should, and we're going to have a little bit of a formal program, but while they are driving, can we please congratulate all these amazing young people, the class of 2020. Okay, just a quick audience question by survey. How many people today honk your horn if this is the first time you've had to tie a tie in forever? Just you. Well, thanks for dressing up. The rest of you, come on. All right, this is a very exciting time. We're very proud of everybody from Central Memorial High School. I was reading up on Central. You guys have roots to 1888. 1888, and in all those 130-some years, this is the first drive-through grad in the history of that school, in the history of the country, and you guys are part of it. So congratulations for doing something exceptional, even though maybe you didn't plan it. It's an exceptional day for all of you. I want to read something important, and we all know it, but I want to read it anyway. We would like to acknowledge we are on the traditional territories of the people of Treaty 7 region in southern Alberta, which includes the Blackfoot Confederacy, the Siksika, the Piikani, and the Kainai First Nations, the Tsuut'ina First Nation, and the Stoney Nakoda, including the Chiniki, Bears Paw, and Wesley First Nation. The city of Calgary is also home to the Métis Nation of Alberta, Region 3. Where we are right here today on the Stampede Grounds is right down the road, or down the river, is where the bow meets the elbow. And that traditional Blackfoot name is Mokinsis, which we now call the City of Calgary. Can we thank those who came before us to create this beautiful land of ours? Let's hear it for them. Just because it makes me laugh so much, just one more time. Da, 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 da. Okay, let me explain something here. 98.3, although I think you all know that if you want to do it. Live stream is on drivethroughgrad2020.com if folks are watching. Don't forget, you can't, as much as you want to throw your caps and throw things out of the car, you can't. So everything that came here has to go with you. It's very simple and fairly straightforward. We're going to do a big group picture at the end, so don't leave early. And I think that's all we need to tell you. We are very proud of this day. We're very proud of this, and we have a video to start our opening of these ceremonies. Have a look.
We've decided to take increasingly aggressive steps to keep you and your family safe.
In particular, mass gatherings are a significant source of concern during this pandemic.
It's hard, but it's the right thing to do.
Is you. This is where you are. Isn't that incredible? Now, your grad is a big deal, and because it's a big deal, The province wanted to make sure that they were involved to tell you how much they're impressed and how excited they are. So, would you please welcome on video the Minister of Education, Adriana LaGrange, and our Premier, Mr. Jason Kenney. Let's hear it for him.
On behalf of the Government of Alberta, we'd like to congratulate all of our grade 12 students across the province who are matriculating this year, graduating from grade 12. You know, normally at this time of year, we see the area behind us filled with grade 12 students celebrating, taking pictures in gowns, and of course, gathering at graduation ceremonies across the province. Sadly, that's not the case this year because of the public health measures around the pandemic, but that doesn't diminish in any way the achievement of our grade 12 students and the hope for the future as they graduate at this time of year.
Class of 2020, I know you're probably very disappointed that you're not able to graduate as other classes have graduated before you, but that shouldn't diminish the extraordinary accomplishments that you have been able to achieve. I want you to go and celebrate in whichever way you can. You have accomplished a lot, having come through, often many of you, from kindergarten all the way through grade 12. That is a wonderful milestone to celebrate. I don't want you to lose sight of that. I want you to ensure that in whichever way you can celebrate, please celebrate that. It's a wonderful accomplishment. You have a great life ahead of you, so please do not stop from celebrating this tremendous, tremendous achievement. We are so very, very proud of you, as is the whole province.
And thanks very much to high school administrators, principals, teachers, parents, and others who have found creative ways of celebrating this important rite of passage for the grade 12 students matriculating this spring during these different times. But to all of you, congratulations on your achievement and all the best in the future.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Isn't that great? Isn't that great? I'm going to do a quick phone call to Tracy. Tracy is in the audience. She's a mom with us here, and I thought it would be great to hear from a parent. So I'm going to try to get a hold of her. Tracy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm well, thanks. How are you?
Tell us a little bit about how you feel about the kids graduating here today, or these young people.
Well, this has turned out to be very exciting. It's been a very sad time for these grads, so we're just so happy that somebody took this on and put on this great event.
And so the people know, Tracy, honk your horn so we know where you are. How many people are you with, Tracy? All right, Tracy, if you could say one thing to the students who are here today, what would you say to them?
The best is yet to come.
The best is yet to come. Let's hear it for Tracy. Thanks, Tracy. Thanks, Mom. Our mayor also wanted to be part of Central's grad, and so he sent a video to you here today. Let's have a look at that.
Hi, I'm Nahid Nenshi, Mayor of Calgary, with a special message for the class of 2020. So here we are. This is not the graduation that you dreamed of. It is not what any of us thought would happen to us this year in 2020. I gotta tell you something. We're going through something that no one living today has ever experienced. And we're going through it together as a community here in Calgary and as a community of human beings around the world. And it may feel like times are tough. We're dealing with a global pandemic. We're dealing with really hard questions around racism, around how we live together as a community, around how we govern ourselves. And we're doing all of that at a time when some of us are feeling very isolated and very alone. But you know what else 2020 has been about? And I don't mean murder hornets. 2020 has been about resilience. It's been about rethinking what's important. It's been about reconnecting with our families. You're gonna have a story for the ages. You're gonna tell your grandkids about what happened in 2020 in your senior year. But what you'll tell them is that you very quickly pivoted. You learned how to learn in a brand new way. Your schools and your teachers did exactly the same thing. You were supported by your families and your loved ones and your friends in order to succeed. And this class succeeded like no other. So congratulations. Congratulations to everyone in the class of 2020. I can't wait to see what you accomplish next.
That is our mayor, Nahed Nenshi. There's a lot of Calgarians that wanted to send messages to you. You would be here till tomorrow if we got them all. But Curtis Dixon, Milan Lucic, Carson Folk, and Dave Dickinson, all athletes and working with the Roughnecks, the Hitmen, the Flames, and the Stampeders, wanted to send their thoughts as well. Have a look.
What is up, 2020 grads? Curtis Dixon here with the Calgary Roughnecks.
Hey guys, it's Milan Lucic here from the Calgary Flames.
Hi, I'm Carson Folk from the Calgary Hitmen.
Hi guys, this is Dave Dickinson, the head coach of the Calgary Stampeders. I've been asked to talk to you guys and congratulate you for being part of the class of 2020.
Graduating high school is a huge accomplishment and you should all be very proud.
You have something solid underneath you now, something that people treasure and will look at you as that you have worked and you've accomplished a goal. Now figure out what the rest of life is gonna hold. What's the next goal? What path do I need to get on in order to get there?
I know times have been a little tough this year.
I know this isn't exactly the way you thought you'd be celebrating.
It's been a crazy, crazy year. So if your path, if your goals are blocked, find a way around them, find a way through them. That's what we're looking for. We love that view from the top. Try to get there. I mean, try to get there, guys. And that's important that you can have to work and find your skills to do it. But I really want to just wish you guys the best of luck. You've made the city of Calgary proud, your parents, yourselves proud. Now go out there and get after it, make the best of it, and congratulations once again on a great job in high school.
A huge congratulations from all of us at the Calgary Hitmen.
Massive congratulations.
I just wanted to congratulate you guys on a big milestone in your lives. All the best in the future, in the next chapter, and stay safe and enjoy what you can with your family and friends.
How about that? I'm going to make another call. Now, if you look around, I'm going to talk to Dorian because I wanted to get a student to chat a bit. Dorian is in this vehicle right here. So if you can see him, he's in the one of the few convertibles. Dorian, how you doing?
Actually, pretty good. It's an exciting time, to say the least.
It is an exciting time, to say the least. Now, did you expect this grad in September?
I expected to go to a grad, but definitely not anything like this. This was unexpected, to say the least.
All right, Dorian, as you look around the group here, what words would you say to your other grads? How does it feel, and what do you feel about your classmates?
I'm glad everybody was able to make it. I didn't have doubts that anybody here was going to be able to push through it. Like, it was definitely a difficult time, but we're all tough people. We're able to get through anything. Woo! We can push through anything, and really, especially through 2020, it's gonna be in the history books, but just toughened us up.
How about that? Let's hear it for your guy, Dorian! Thanks, Dorian! Well, look, there was a few people that said, we want to put a video together that's made and from and to you. This is your graduating video. Have a look at the screen. It's all yours.
Into the gym, and our first day of high school officially began. It was almost as if time had stopped. We shuffled through hallways at an uncomfortable pace and clung to the people we knew from junior high. We were hanging on to the past while being lost in the present. During those first weeks of high school, the thought of graduation had seemed so far away for so long, and now we're here. We made it. And yet, Now those 3 years seem like only a blip in time, as if life sped quickly past us. Who would have thought that blip would turn into 551,880,000 minutes spent collectively in Central's halls? 1 billion cups of coffee drank to the last drop, enough to give us 1 million ulcers. 1,500 tests too many. Countless moments waiting for class to end. 70,000 assignments and thousands of hours spent at home toiling over them. So many seconds to use, so much time flying by. And somehow, we made it to grade 12. Little did we know, our concept of time was about to be flipped on its head. No one knew then how much it would change. While we've been sitting at home, trying to log on to online classes, combating with all the voice drops, technical difficulties, and totally not binge-watching Tiger King, we haven't been thinking about how the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell, that acids and bases have two different faces, how every single humanities teacher wanted their essays written a different way, or how crowded Locker City became at every class change. What we've really been thinking about are the connections we made with our peers and the relationships we were able to build with each one of our teachers. Let's be honest, the true reason we came to school every day wasn't for the curriculum, but the people and the communities that we were able to build in such a short time. Grad is supposed to allow us to tie up these relationships we've built and truly say goodbye to high school, but with recent events, we've had to adapt. Who could have ever imagined that grad would look this way? Life has thrown something terrifying and unknown at us. We had expected to be able to spend some of our last moments here with our friends, creating memories that we could carry with us for the rest of our lives. But those memories look a lot different than what we had previously predicted. Our clocks have been turned upside down, and the meaning of time has lost its significance. We followed the rules, worked our way through high school, grew up, and were ready for the gripping conclusion to what we would remember as the good old days. I know it doesn't seem like things will ever go back to normal, that we've missed the chance to see the proud looks on our guardians' faces as they see us walk the stage, or that we won't get to revel in the moment with friends that have been by our side since the beginning. However, in many ways, our grad will be the most memorable one for many generations. It's distinct and unique. And when we're old and gray, our grandchildren will be asking us what it was like to graduate in the year 2020. In the wise words of Ferris Bueller, life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you might miss it. While we can't necessarily follow this advice right now, we will eventually be able to take the future in our own hands and determine how we want to live our lives and what our journeys will look like. We are the next generation. And I'd say, the future is in good hands.
Hello there. Remember me?
It seems like so very long ago, ages ago, that I stood up in front of you to welcome you back after last summer, our class of 2020. I recall the great cheer that went up, the expectations high for your final year of high school. Graduation looming, just a few scant months in the distance. I think I was almost as excited as you. You see, you are my first complete 3-year class of students since I arrived at Central just over 3 years ago. The first group of students I'd had the privilege to know since you all arrived, fresh-faced and perhaps a little intimidated, on that first day of grade 10. The year got underway. Teams played, pep rallies happened, concerts were performed, dance recitals, plays, musicals, tournaments, competitions. Oh yes, and classes were held too, and attended by some of you more than others. You know who you are. There were countless assignments done and tests and exams written, so many tests. We finished classes on December 19th and off we went on our winter break. Sometime late in December, before New Year's, we began hearing about this virus with the strange, almost humorous name. Jokes about Mexican beer came out, remember? We started back in January to classes, and still, what was happening in faraway province of China, in a little known city named Wuhan, seemed, well, so far away. Life in Calgary carried on. Life at Central Memorial in the CT Center carried on. Plans for graduation really started to take shape. Dresses bought, limos checked out. Well, as S.E. Hinton famously said, that was then and this is now. To say we are living in a strange, surreal world is an understatement of epic proportions. Each day, it seems, continues to bring fresh challenges to face, new problems to solve. In many ways, my heart breaks for you, class of 2020. You have woken up and through absolutely no fault of your own, found yourselves in this terrible situation, and it isn't fair. The plans you had for graduation, for the celebration, for the parties, rudely snatched away. Opportunities to finish courses, and for many of you, to prepare for post-secondary programs, turned upside down as you and your teachers struggled to figure out how to do most of it online now. And for some of you, the constant worry, and perhaps even the loss of a loved family member or friend or neighbor. Terrible indeed. These are some of the cards you have been dealt, my friends, and no, it just isn't fair. However, I want to suggest that you have also been given some gifts that go along with these dark, challenging times. Some of you, many of you I suspect, know what I mean. You see, class of 2020, events such as this pandemic offer us some tremendous opportunities as well. You have some choices to make, and many of you are well into making them. You can sit back and be stuck in that this just isn't fair place, or you can choose to get up, dust yourself off, and move past that very unproductive and not very helpful mindset. I've seen and heard of the things many of you are doing, even in isolation. Sure, you're spending too many hours on social media and likely watching far too much Netflix. I mean, seriously, Tiger King? But you're also, many of you, perhaps most, doing beautifully well with your online courses, all things considered. You're making music, dancing, cooking dinner, baking bread, competing in provincial skills competitions, calling grandparents, going for walks with your dogs and with your families, rediscovering deeper relationships with friends and loved ones. And some of you are growing your first gardens, delivering groceries to neighbors, and helping little sisters and brothers with their online homework. These are all choices you have made as a very positive response to the challenge of COVID-19. And you and the world are better off as a result. Never doubt that. I want you all to use this pandemic as a launching point for you to declare and create a new improved version of yourself. Imagine the power of this. There are about 385 of you. Use this, an opportunity to become a more compassionate, kinder you. We have our own Canadian versions of George Floyd. Trust me, racism is not an American thing exclusively. Imagine the offsetting and tremendous impact in the world of 385 of you dedicated to treating everyone they encounter throughout their lives with dignity, respect, compassion, and love. I see it already with my new improved 2020 vision. Pun absolutely intended. Recently, a Central Memorial parent very kindly sent me a piece of anonymous writing, and I'd like to share a little of it with you. Heal your own heart and cherish your own body and celebrate your own soul. Then go out there and live, love, make a difference. End quote. You got this. Congratulations to the very wonderful and absolutely indomitable class of 2020. I'm very proud of each and every one of you.
Congratulations!
Woo-hoo!
Come on, how about that? Now, for all the grads, I just want to warn you of something. There are parents, step-parents, grandparents, uncles and aunts, big brothers, caretakers, who are going to look at you and say, I remember it was just yesterday when you were going in kindergarten. And you're going to say, Dad, that's the 15th time today you said that. But they can't help themselves because your parents, step-parents, and caregivers are so proud, so very proud that you are what you are. So congratulations to you and thanks to all the folks who took care of you. Now, those of us who helped put some of this together wanted to give you a gift as well. So we did a little video, just a short one. And then when that's done, we're going to take a grad picture of all of you. And believe me, it is the only picture in the history of grad pictures that's going to look like this. Before we do that, have a look at our video.
If you ask your parents what they remember about their grad, what they wore or how they got there, or what anyone even said at their grad, they won't have a clue. No one ever does. But not this time, not your grad. Your parents will remember today. Your friends will remember today, and you will remember today. You'll even remember the car you took to get here because you drove the car right to the stage, then walked across this stage in front of your car, then got back in your car and watched everyone else do the same from their car while you sat in your car. So, where does that leave you? It leaves you with the chance to go from a grad that no one has experienced before to a life no one has lived before. You get to choose what really is essential. What does the world really need, and who do I really want to be in it? Because clearly the world needs you. Choose to help because we need it. Choose to lead because we need leaders. Choose to be courageous because this is a time that calls for courage. And someday, some of you might have kids, and someday those kids will graduate high school, and they'll say to you, do you even remember your grad? And you'll pull out a picture of a parking lot, and you'll say, yes, I do. That was the year everything changed. It was the start of something great, and I was right there in the middle of it. Let's drive our cars into the future. Congratulations, class of 2020, the class that started it all, the class that no one will ever forget.